to be successful Saturday night. This will be the second championship, two-time world champion. He's going on a tremendous, tremendous run.
Now, it's been a while since he's fought. How is like?
Oh, since June.
Since June. Well, I mean, big fight. In terms of like a Mew or a Danger. How's the reception been to bring him back to the bar?
It's great. I mean, it's a world championship fight. You know, every fight that I was involved with, except for the last fight, Steve Rolls' fight, was a world championship fight. So that's all we knew. This is, like I said, I think it's going to be the second part of his career. Two-time world champion, and he's excited. You can see it's an extra step, the extra effort. Training camp, you know, it's a second fight with Jonathan Banks, and you gotta say the chemistry really turned out great with Jonathan. Jonathan had a great run with Vladimir Klitschko, who's one of the best middle heavyweights that we've seen in recent times, and now Gennady's one of the best middleweights we've seen in recent times. So Jonathan was right there with the top trainers of all the top athletes in boxing, so we're really excited about that. I know that Jonathan has Gennady locked and loaded to show his explosiveness on Saturday night.
Gennady was saying that he was asked about we need to do a better job of asking better questions. So it seems like he's tired of answering those questions. Yeah. How about you? Are you tired of answering questions about a possible fight?
We're focused on the guys who will actually get in the ring with them and fight him. You know, we made two Canelo fights, which were very hard at the time. When they were scheduled to fight in September, that proved, for whatever reason, not to be possible on the Canelo side. But Gennady's the type of guy. He's going to fight Sergey Dmytrenko. It's a tough fight in its own right. Canelo has a tough fight against Kovalev. But Gennady's never been the guy to back down from a challenge. And if that third fight happens, it's going to be a great fight. But right now, he's focused on Dmytrenko. And we'll go from there.
Tom. With Canelo kind of out of the picture for right now, is there a possibility that Triple G would take that trip to Tokyo to fight Murata?
I think you know, that's a fight that we've been talking about for a while. Murata being very popular in Japan, he's fought over here a couple of times, and I think that would, Gennady's the type of guy who likes to fight. It doesn't matter where he fights. But that's one fight that would intrigue him, to go to Japan, fight Murata in his home country. I think that would be a huge event over there in Japanese boxing. And Triple G would bring his big drama show on the road, like he's done many times before in England, in Monte Carlo, in Ukraine, in Germany, in Kazakhstan. He's pretty much fought all over the world. And to fight in Japan would be a tremendous opportunity. Right now he's focused on Saturday night. If he's successful, I definitely think we could see a Murata fight sometime down the road.
And to put it in perspective, how many people do you think you could get attendance-wise for the Murata?
Oh, I think that's a huge fight, especially in Japan. That's a huge fight in the sport of boxing, but especially in Japanese boxing. That would be that'd be a tremendous response. We know how popular Murata is in Japan. He's a folk hero over there. He's a world champion. He's Olympic champion. And to bring someone like Triple G there to his home country, I think that would be an electric event over in Japan.
You guys really want the third fight? Is this something you're going to have to start demanding?
Look, we can jump up and down and scream as much as we want. That doesn't mean Canelo's going to get in the ring. We thought when Gennady fought, when he signed with the Zone, it would make that fight easier. Instead of before the negotiations were on the pay-per-view splits and there was always a lot of contentions there with the Zone, you don't have that aspect of the negotiation. We thought it'd be a pretty smooth sailing. Obviously, Canelo had different plans. So right now he's focused on Dmytrenko. He's focused on the guy that would get in the ring with him. And arguably, the winner of this fight will be the best middleweight champion in the world.
Gennady getting another belt?
I think it's huge. He's motivated. You know, before when we were trying to unify, he had all the belts except for one. We couldn't get that WBO belt from Billy Joe Saunders. So right now, this will be the start of, you know, he wants to collect all the belts. I know he's focused on the bigger fights that are out there for him. Dmytrenko is a huge fight, and it's a big fight for this stage of his career. If he's successful, he's a two-time world champion. Canelo fighter at 175. puts Gennady in the best middleweight.
Hey Tom, what are the likelihood of finding any of the PBC fighters like a Jared Hurd or Jamal Charlo? Maybe even people said Errol Spence would go to 160 for Canelo. Would that be
those
any
are
of those
all
guys?
Great fights. Charlo, we've talked about that fight for a long time. Errol wants to come up to 160. You know, look, PBC has a lot of great fighters. Like I said, Jared Hurd would be a tremendous fight. Caleb Plant, 168. And there's a lot of talent that they have. You know, the likelihood of making that, that's a whole different story. You know, a lot of times the dollars make fights possible. DAZN has a big budget, and which will allow to make fights like the Devonchenko fight or potentially someone from the PBC. So you know, we're always open to it. Gennady's always wanted to fight the best. They got some tremendous talent. Al's done a great job building those fighters up, and so if that's possible, you know, from the Triple G side, it's not going to be a problem.
You said 168 for Caleb Plant. Would that mean he'll go down, or would Triple G actually consider going up to 168?
Triple G has always considered going to 168 as long as it was the right opportunity. It had to be a big fight for him to move to 168. The big fights, you know, biggest fight at one for him in his career was Canelo at 160 pounds. You know, there was talk about him fighting Chavez at 168 when Chavez was still in the prime of his career. There was talk of him going to Wembley Stadium, fighting Carl Froch at 168, selling out Wembley Stadium. So those are two huge events that he would have moved to 168 for. Other than that, you know, Canelo was clearly the biggest fight that we could make, and that's why he stayed at 160 to focus on that fight. Now, you know, we'll see. We'll see who's at 160. If there's a good opportunity at 168, we'll consider it. But if he had the choice, he would stay at 160 because he feels comfortable that way.
Tom, if I could switch gears for a second, the other fighter you have that I'm a big fan of is Cecilia Brekus.
Yes.
What is she? I've been seeing pictures of her training and, yeah, and whatnot online. Does she have something set up?
We're working on her next fight right now. Hopefully we'll have an announcement here within the next week or so. And a lot of fans want to see her back in action.
Yeah.
She's the undisputed welterweight champion, best female boxer pound for pound. And so hopefully we'll have an announcement here soon. She is in training camp, and we're just trying to work out the deal for our next fight.
Because Clarissa is obviously fighting on Saturday as well. If she comes out victorious, is that still a possibility, or is that something that was just kind of talked about and not really?
There's always a possibility. I think with Clarissa, the weight difference is too drastic because she came down from 168 to 160.
Yeah.
Now she's fighting 154, so we'll have to see how she looks at 154. Cecilia has fought her entire career at 147. Mm-hmm. She makes 147 very easily.
Mm-hmm.
You know, look, Caressa in her own right is blazing her own trail. I think this will be the third division that she'll be a champion of if she's successful, which she should be. So, you know, the door is always open. We just have to see, you know, if they were in the same division, it'd be easy to make it. Caressa came to 147, it'd be easy to make that fight. For Cecilia to go to a fight to a weight where she's never fought at before, after everything that she's accomplished, I don't know how feasible that would be, but you know, like I said, we're going to focus on her next fight, see what Clarissa does, and then see where everything goes.
All right, thank you, man. Appreciate you.
Thank you. All right, see you.